Wouldn't you like to spend just a little bit of this time of the night with me and some friends? If you wanna, then it'll be all right. 'Cause I can hear the music play as the rhythm of the night begins. So if you wanna come on in, it'll be just fine. Hello, everybody. One happy song, now here's another one. When you smile, I can see that you were born for me, and for me you will be, do or die. Oh baby, let me hold you, you make me wanna hold you. When you smile, 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 smile. When you smile, I can see there is hope, hope for me and for you, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna sock it to you, I'm gonna rock it to you. You know I
ladies and gentlemen, Roger Kitter.
Lulu, I want to teach you to do Tommy Cooper tonight.
I thought you did. I just got that. Yeah,
just
I got that
hunch.
Feeling. Yes.
Watch me.
All right.
Thank you very much.
I'm sorry I'm late, but I had trouble coming here tonight. Oh. I tried to thumb a lift, and I couldn't find one. Just cars.
Okay,
your turn. Put the hat on.
All right, put the hat on.
Right.
Right.
Now stand like that. Just like that.
Just like that. I went to the doctor's this morning. I said, I swallowed a spoon. He said, sit down and don't stir.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight I want to talk to you about relaxation because everyone has their own way of relaxing. I mean, some people like to watch football on television. I did up until the England against Poland match last week. Of course, Brian Clough was there, and he was... Yes, remember him? He was in the bar having his usual drink, right water. You know, when he resigned, all the Derby supporters wanted him to go back. They were all running down the street shouting, get Clough, get Clough. And he was asked what he thought of the England against Poland match. He said, well, you know, David, he said, how can England be expected to beat the Poles when Sir Alf's up the pole? Of course, you can always take up a hobby. I mean, my brother collects coins. There's a special name for that, a miser. One friend of mine runs one of those mail order catalogues. An auntie of mine bought one of those 90s from it, which was stretched over 20 weeks. You should see what it's stretched over now. And mind you, who cares? There's too many spoil sports around, like Mary Whitehouse. I see now she wants to take the pawn out of the game of chess. And there are games, of course, that you can do, and there's other things you can do, like, for example, you can relax and win money at the same time. Bingo. My auntie loves it. Do you know she won £250 last week playing bingo? Only cost her 700 quid. And I won a lot of money at cards last week. I was playing snap with Patrick Campbell. But you know, the funny thing is, you can always have a go at the football pools. I try that, but I've never been very lucky. In fact, I sometimes don't even get the cross right for no publicity. And I love driving. That's my favourite pastime. I love to get away from it all on the big, wide open road with nobody else around. And then the car breaks down and I'm cursing because I'm right away from it all, the big, wide open road with nobody else around. I went to the motor show this year and, well, I was interested to see what's going to be making up next year's traffic jams. And I think Jimmy Savile has done more for the car recently with his safety campaigns than anybody else. And I wonder, could you imagine him as a salesman at the motor show? And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and guys and gals, and all you guys and gallon users. And that was about that then. And welcome to the fantastic motor show this year. We've got some fantastic cars for you. We've got some wonderful new cars for my favourite dancers, Pan's People, Allegro. Guys and gals, actually, yours truly has just got himself a new Rolls Royce, and it's so big I can only park it half at a time. And I want you to listen now, guys and gals, I want you to listen to this fantastic new horn, which has been designed especially for me. It's called the Savile Row. How's about that then? For all you guys and gals who want to get into the top of the charts, it's got its own speedometer, which starts at 20 and goes to number one. How's about that then?
Well, my next guest used to be the lead singer with Blood, Sweat and Tears, but now he's making a name for himself as a solo singer. Here he is, David Clayton Thomas.
Got mad and closed the door. But you said, child, just once more, I chose you for the one. Now we're having so much fun. You treated me so kind, I'm about to lose my mind. You made me so world. loving you. I'd spend my whole life with you. Cause you came and you took control. You touched my very soul. You always showed me that loving you is where it's at. You made me so very happy, and I'm so glad you came into my life. Yeah, tell me about it. Thank you, babe. Love you. Oh, yeah, yeah. I love you so much, you see. You're even in my dreams. I can hear you, baby. You know I can hear you calling me. I'm so in love with you. All I ever want to do is just thank you, baby. Thank you, baby.
England, David.
Back to England, indeed. I was born in England. Did you know that?
I didn't know that. Where were you born?
Walton-on-Thames.
My goodness, you can't get any more English than that.
I'm a Canadian. I was raised in Canada, but my granny and my granddad still live in Walton-on-Thames.
Isn't that funny?
It is.
And the song we're going to sing is a long way from Walton-on-Thames.
Mississippi.
Yeah.
Clarksdale, Mississippi, the land of the cotton.
Shall we do it?
Let's do it.
Okay.
From the land of the cotton, a land that was nearly forgotten by everyone. And she worked and slaved so hard. A cotton field was her backyard in the Delta land.
Love it.
But oh, but she sure could sing. Oh, 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 she sure could sing. Sing for me, girl.
She looked down upon her and he took pity. Said, what you sure could see. Yeah.
She had faith and she had believing.
She sure did.
She led the people all together in singing praises of joy to the Lord up above. Sing it for me.
Singing songs in the heat by the river.
She would lead them all together.
Oh, yeah. But she sure could sing. Yes, she could.
Whoa,
but she sure could sing.
She had faith and she had believing.
She led the people
all together in singing praises of joy to the Lord of the blood. Sing it for me.
To get them. I'm torn between an electric toaster, a dinner service, and a swing top waste bin.
Oh, I should get the waste bin.
Do you think so?
Yeah, it's cheapest. They load all the toast they can burn and still have room for the broken dinner service.
Eddie, there is much more to marriage than broken dinner services and burnt toast.
So you say, I've yet to be convinced. I'll tell you one thing, when I get married...
When?
If. Oh. I get married, I'm not sending out lists like that. They've got everything they need for life down there.
Well, people who lead normal married life need things like this.
Newlyweds who want an electric blanket don't sound normal to me. And what the extra sooty linen basket?
Well, it's a linen basket shaped like sooty and the head lifts off. It's a novelty for their bedroom.
Novelty for their bedroom, eh?
And it'll come in handy if they have kids.
If? Ha!
What is ha supposed to mean?
Oh, nothing. Only hope she doesn't have the cheek to get married in white, that's all.
Eddie Walters, are you insinuating...
Well, it's either that or she'd be making a pig of herself with the Yorkshire puddings.
Honestly, your mind. Sheila's boyfriend's not like you, you know.
No, he's luckier.
What I mean is, he's not trying it on every 5 minutes. He wouldn't stoop to that sort of thing.
He wouldn't have to. She's taller than him.
That's terrific. That's really great. I'd be very pleased if you keep your cheap remarks to yourself. My friend is getting married because she wants to, not because she has to.
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. He wouldn't have the energy anyhow. He only has to kiss, he has to lie down for half an hour.
Would you mind if we got back to this list?
Yeah, all right.
Thank you very much. How about some cooking utensils?
Oh, that's a good idea, yeah. A set of can openers, a gross of baked beans, and an asbestos pan.
There is nothing wrong with Sheila's cooking. With a little bit of practice, it could be quite,
edible? Oh, come on, the last time she was around your place, she burnt 4 pans boiling an egg.
Sheila is my best friend, and Saturday's going to be the happiest day of her life.
Yeah, after that, it's all downhill.
Eddie, marriage isn't like that. It's togetherness, thoughtfulness, and making sacrifices for each other.
Making sacrifices of each other, you mean?
You don't understand. Marriages are made in heaven.
The way most of them work, you think they were made in Hong Kong.
You see the worst in everything. Doesn't marriage mean anything to you?
Of course it does. Lots of presents, good booze up with your mates.
What about love? Doesn't love come into it?
Yeah, I love a good booze up with me mates.
I see. Well, if that's what you think, what am I doing sitting here?
Waiting for another donut.
That's right. That's about all I've got to look forward to. No white wedding, no home of my own. Just a donut that's been on the shelf longer than I have.
Oh, look, Shirl.
Shirley.
Shirley?
Shirley Adamson.
Eh?
Miss Shirley Adamson. Spinster of this and any other parish you care to mention.
Look, we've been through all this before. I've told you, I'm not ready for marriage yet.
Well, I am.
You've been ready since our second date. You've had a bottom drawer since you were 15. In fact, by now, you must have a chest of drawers full of bottom drawers.
That's right. Make fun at me. Shatter my dreams. I'd throw your engagement ring right in your face, if I had one.
Look, Shirl, Shirley, I'm not saying that we'll never get married. We will.
Will we?
Yes. In fact, your talking of engagement rings has reminded me.
What's that reminded you of, Eddie?
Diamonds Are Forever's on at the Plaza. You want to see it?
Segment with a Carmen hoedown. Now here's a popular and very lovely song.
Don't look so sad. I know it's over, but life goes on, and this old world keeps on turning. Let's just be glad we had some time to spend together. There's no need to watch the bridges that we're burning. Lay your head upon my pillow. Hold your warm and tender body close to mine. Softness of the raindrops
children. Now I'd like you to meet our two little friends. Hello. Hello. Don't they look bright and cheerful?
Oh, built up.
Don't they look bright and cheerful? How can you look bright and cheerful when you've had your shoulder dislocated twice in 1 week?
They don't know what they're on about, them two up there, honestly.
Hello. She must be putting a fag in her mouth.
Hello, now he's lighting it for her. Oh, wait till he shakes the match out. That's the bit I hate. There he goes, up and down like a flaming yo-yo.
Yes, well, I just hope them two don't have another row. Oh. When she waves her arms about, she has me jumping up and down like horse of the year.
Oh. Now, children, they're going to do their little dance for you.
Here we go. Be lucky if I get through this lot without a hernia.
Oh, I don't think I could take much more of this.
Look, their coordination's gone. Yeah, well, you know why that is, don't you?
Of course. Too much of that, innit?
On top of all that, I think I've got dry rot.
What do you think you're doing?
It wasn't me, was it? It's them up there.
Yeah, well, just watch it. Because last night you had your hand right up my...
I know. It's them up there. I don't know what day it is. Mm. Do you remember last Wednesday?
Will I ever forget? Talk about getting us tangled up together. I'm just glad Lord Longford wasn't watching that.
Last tangle in Paris.
Well, that's all for today, children. So, bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Stand by. This is it.
That's charming, isn't it? Go off and leave us lying here like a pile of old timber.
Yeah. Still, we don't need them, do we?
What do you mean?
Well, we will now.
I'm not that friend, you know.
I've got no strings to hold me down, to make me fret or make me frown. I had strings, but now I'm free. There are no strings on me. Hi-ho, the merry-o. I'm as happy as can be. I want the world to know nothing ever worries me. Not tied up to anyone. How I love my liberty. There are no strings on me.
Show.
What are you doing up there?
Of course, this young man's holding me up here, that's right. Otherwise, I'd be flat on my backside. That's right. Thank you very much for the lift, young man.
Done him in.
That'll put him out of action for a year or two, won't it? Yes.
What are you doing here? I'm sorry, but you're not supposed to be...
Yeah, Mr. Bruce Ford, I've got my ticket, look.
But this is for the Generation Game.
That's right, I'm a contestant. Now, let me see. Big teddy bear, electric trouser press, a pair of non-stick underwear, pop-up kettle.
Just a minute.
Chocolate.
Just a minute. I think you're a wee bit confused.
Hey, you're a jock, aren't you? You're a Scotty.
That's right, I'm from Glasgow.
Yes, I knew a Scotty once, you know. 6'4" he was.
Oh, really?
Yes, had one of the finest soprano voices I've ever heard.
6'4" and a soprano.
That's right. Well, he went home drunk one night, you see, and he dropped his sporran, and he bent down to put it on again, and that's when he made his mistake.
What happened?
It turned out to be a badger.
Quite fascinating, yes.
Yes, well, now, if you'll tell young Anthea that I'm here...
Look, the generation game is finished. It's over. You're too late.
Do you mean to say I've come all the way from Walthamstow East for nothing?
I'm sorry.
Do you know I fought for this country, I did.
Mr...
Hang on a minute. The electric trousers... James Maynard Kitchener Lampwick.
Well, it's very nice to meet you, Mr.
What's your name?
Lulu.
Lulu? That's the same as the little Scotch girl on the... Here, wait a minute. You're not her, are you?
Yes, I am.
Oh, fancy me standing here talking to you. All the lads down at the boozer went off, and they'll never believe me. You're a pretty little thing, aren't you?
Well, you're not so bad yourself.
You know, I like them young ladies. I like them young ladies on your show that do the dancing. They're beautiful, aren't they?
They are, yes. But I would have thought you would have sort of lost interest in the girls.
Oh,
you know?
Let me tell you, there may be snow on the roof, but there's still fire in the grate, aren't there? Oh, yes, of course, you know, in my day, young day, we never saw anything like that. We never saw as much as even an ankle we didn't see.
No?
No, until I was 14, I thought ladies went about on little wheels.
But you must have...
Hang on.
But you must admit, yes, those long dresses they used to wear and those little boots, yes, made them look very feminine. Yes, they were very, yes, feminine.
Here, you just turn your head for a moment.
What's wrong? Have I got a smudge on my nose?
No. Do you know who you remind me of?
No.
My missus. Yes, it wasn't until you mentioned the long dresses and you being in that one, a pair of eye button boots would be the spitting image of her.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, that's nice.
I still miss her, you know.
Oh, do you?
Well, I mean, 50 years together is a long time, isn't it, eh?
Yeah.
Mind you, I'm not saying we never had a cross word. Oh, no. In fact, we had our first row on our honeymoon.
What happened?
Well, we went down to Ramsgate, you see, to this boarding house, and my missus said to me, she said, now, whatever you do, don't tell them we're just married, otherwise I'll get very embarrassed.
Yeah.
Anyway, the next morning, we come down to breakfast, and they're all nudging one another and looking at us and sniggering, you know. She said, I told you not to tell them I was newlywed. So I said, never mind, love. I said, as a matter of fact, I told them we weren't even married. Yes, I'm fine.
Well, Mr. Lampwick, it's been very nice meeting you. I've got to go and change, but you will stay and watch the rest of the show, won't
Certainly,
you?
Certainly, my dear.
Nice meeting you. Bye-bye.
What a lovely little thing she is. Yeah, she does remind me of my missus. What times we had in those days, those musical evenings round the piano. Me with a pint of beer in my hand, her with a white wine. You're just as lovely today as you were yesterday. Yesterday was many years ago. You always smiled through the years, and that is what endears you to me. You see, we've had our good times and our bad, our share of times when you made me sad. But it fills me with pride that you stayed by my side, and I'm thankful for the years to come that we haven't had. All our tomorrows look good, had an idea that they would. The happy day you said you'd marry me, and now that we're all alone, the kids are on their own. Once more, you belong to me. Don't you know what I'm trying to say? In me own funny kind of way. Just as lovely today as you were yesterday. Do you remember when we first met? You moved into our street, and although I was only 12 years old, I knew you were the one for me. Took me a year to pluck up enough courage to talk to you, and when I did, my voice cracked. Fancy fancy me choosing a moment like that for my voice to break, but bless your heart, you didn't laugh at me. We went out together for a long time after that until war broke out and I joined the army. And you waited for me. And thank God you did. Because now, today, after all these years, you're even more lovely, more beautiful than Gina Lollobridge. Gina Lollobridge. Oh, you know who I mean. All our tomorrows look good. Had an idea that they would. The happy day you said you'd marry me. And now that we're all alone, the kids are on their own. Once more, you belong to me. Don't you know what I'm trying to say? In me own funny kind of way. You're just as lovely today as you were yesterday. Don't you know what I'm trying to say? In my own funny kind of way. Yeah, you're just as lovely today as you were yesterday.
I'm so lonely, I could die. Love me tender, love me sweet. Never let me go. And my darling, I love you.
Well, that's it for this week. I hope you'll join me next week, when my guests will be Roy Hudd, the New Seekers, and Engelbert Humperdinck. See you then. Good night.